Every physical variable, distance, time, mass, speed, energy, and so on, has units of measurement. For example, the agreed upon international unit of speed and of velocity is the meter per second, abbreviated M over S, M divided by S. Sometimes international units are inconvenient. For example, if you happen to be speeding in the United States, you might need to convert between meters per second and miles per hour. Or to talk about continental drift, you might need to convert between meters per second and centimeters per century. This video presents a systematic way to change the units of physical variables, to convert from one set of units to another. The conversion technique is purely mathematical, and it's simple. It requires only that you treat units algebraically, just as you would treat numbers and variables. In fact, the heart of the units conversion process is multiplying by one. If you can multiply by one, you can change units. The challenge is to multiply by the right kind of one. Huh? Let's do a simple example. Suppose I want to convert 5 miles into meters. 5 miles equals how many meters? Of course, to do this, I must know how many meters there are in a mile. Any good physics book and any good internet web browser will tell you that 1 mile equals approximately 1,600, that is 1,600 meters. By the way, most web browsers will do the conversion for you right in the search line. But the idea here is what's important. This is one of those times when being able to do the calculation yourself is an important skill. 1 mile is approximately 1,600 meters. The more accurate value is 1.6093440 times 10 to the third meters. But perhaps the accuracy gods will forgive us for using just 1,600 meters. Since we can treat the units just as if they were numbers, let's divide both sides of this equation by mile. Then 1 equals 1,600 meters per mile, meters divided by mile. There it is. That's the form of 1 that we need in order to perform the conversion. 5 miles times 1,600 meters per mile equals 5 times 1,600 meters equals 8,000 meters. Notice that when we multiply by 1,600 meters per mile, we are just multiplying by 1. So we don't really change the distance of 5 miles, we just change its units. 1,600 meters per mile is called a conversion factor. All conversion factors are like this. They equal the number 1. But that 1 is expressed as a ratio of units. Here are some other commonly known conversion factors. 1 equals 60 seconds per minute. 1 equals 60 minutes per hour. 1 equals 2.54 centimeters per inch. Notice that the reciprocal of each conversion factor is also a conversion factor. 1 equals 1/60th minute per second. It also equals 1/60th hour per minute. And 1 equals 1 divided by 2.54 inches per centimeter. Let's do another example, a harder one, to show how the process works with speed units. In radical physics video number 6, RP6, we calculated the average speed of a world-class sprinter to be 10 meters per second. Let's convert this speed to miles per hour. V sub sprinter equals 10 meters per second equals how many miles per hour? We need to multiply by the number 1 several times so that the speed stays the same, but the units change. Here are the forms of 1 that we need. 1 equals 1,600 meters per mile, which is 1 over 1,600 miles per meter. 1 equals 60 seconds per minute, and 1 equals 60 minutes per hour. Let's deal with the time units before dealing with the distance units. We'll see why soon. The speed of the sprinter equals 10 meters per second times 60 seconds per minute equals 600 meters per minute. And 600 meters per minute times 60 minutes per hour equals 36,000 meters per hour. But we want miles per hour, not meters per hour. So we need to multiply by the number 1, that is by a conversion factor, that will cancel meters in the numerator and put miles in its place.
1 equals 1,600 meters per mile equals 1 over 1,600 miles per meter.
V sub sprinter equals 36,000 meters per hour times 1 over 1,600 miles per meter equals 36,000 divided by 1,600 miles per hour, which is 22.5 miles per hour. So a speed of 10 meters per second is between 22 and 23 miles per hour. You're a very good sprinter if you can run alongside a car going a little bit faster than 22 miles per hour. Let's see the whole process expressed in a single line of algebra. V sprinter equals 10 meters per second times 60 seconds per minute times 60 minutes per hour times 1 over 1600 miles per meter. That's a lot of multiplying by 1. And look at how those units cancel. The speed of a sprinter is 22.5 miles per hour. This process of multiplying by various forms of the number 1, that is, various conversion factors, is powerful. It's all we'll ever need to convert from one set of units to another.